Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We're happy to be here this morning. The Lord will grant you all your desires.
Amen.
Your coming here will not be in vain.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. We want to go straight to the word of God as the occasion demands. If you have your Bible in your hand, you lift it up above your head and say after me, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
The word of God.
The word of God.
And what it says I am,
I
shall not die.
I will live
to testify
to
the goodness of the Lord.
I will speak
as I'm led by the Spirit.
I will do
all He wants me to do.
And
I will be
who He
wants
me to be.
And
my life
will never remain the same. If you believe
that,
shout the loudest, amen.
Amen.
Here I am. Send me. Send me, Lord. Here I am. Here I am.
Send me, Lord.
Ask
the Lord
wants somebody, Lord.
Here I am.
Here I am.
Send me.
Use me, Lord. This morning to hear from you. Lord, speak to us. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Every contrary spirit that is hanging around to cause confusion in our midst, we send you packing.
Amen.
And you are banished.
Amen.
Never to appear here again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray, my Father, as the word will be coming, give us a hearing ear.
Amen.
Let our heart become a heart that receive your word.
Amen.
And understand your word.
Amen.
To the glory of your name.
Amen.
Any spirit of misinterpretation, you are cursed.
Amen.
You will never grow in us.
Amen.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Put your hands together. Take your seat. Thanks be to God for His word. I like to treat His word as it is. The declaration was made our month of praise. And for you to be a praiseful child of God, you must believe in God. If you cannot believe God, you will never praise Him. You will never praise Him. To be a praiseful child of God, you will see you have security. If you are a praiseful child of God, you are secured here on earth. No devil will tamper you. I put down the word here as praise guarantees victory. Praise guarantee what? Your victory. When you praise God, you'll be victorious. There's no two ways about it. Look at what happened in the life of the Israelites. Through their leader, Moses, after God has completed His work on behalf of the Israelites, they sang a song and they worshipped Him. They praised Him. Why? For the completed victory He has given to them. So you can't receive from God without you knowing. They were tempted. They faced persecution. They faced a lot of trial. But God stood by them. At the end of it all, they sang a song. They praised God. They worshiped Him. Exodus chapter number 15. We start from there this morning. You look at that word praise is to honor God for the job or the work he has done on behalf of his people. Praise is honoring God, letting him know that what he did was good. Praise and worship is a celebration of God's victory for his children. When we praise God, we see God doing more for us. We cannot praise God and praise amiss, but we can pray and pray amiss. But when we are praising God, we see God proving, yes, I am God. Praise the Lord. The Almighty God will not fail us. When we praise him, he will not fail us. Verse 1 of Exodus chapter 15, I said. Verse 1. Then Moses and the children of Israel sang this song to the Lord and spoke, saying, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. He defeated them that wanted them dead. God made the children of Israel to sing a song. Why? Because he defeated all his enemies. He rendered them powerless. He disarmed them and gave the children of Israel victory. In verse 2, the Lord is my strength and song, and he has become my salvation. He is my God. And I will do what? I will praise him, my father's God. I will exalt him. For what he has done, I will keep on praising him. You can't praise God and regret. There is no way you will praise God and begin to regret. Why did I praise God, sir? No. It's a lie. You can't praise God and regret. When your circumstances come as it comes, you go down to God. When you go down to God, God will lift you up. First book of Chronicles. I see many of us celebrating this year.
Amen.
Every one of us will celebrate this year.
Amen.
Jesus in our heart, celebration continues.
Amen.
Let it be known to you. What is important is to know who you are following. Know the God you are serving. If you know the God you are serving, is no respecter of any man. If he has done it in the time past, he will still do it now. He will do it. No matter the challenges you are facing, well, we shake, right, because we are human beings. But when it comes, burst into praise. Begin to call God all manner of names, sweet, 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 sweet names. You will see him hailing you, carry on my son, carry on my daughter. And you get to where they wanted you to die. You begin to see God proving that he is the Almighty. He's Almighty. He cannot lie. There is nowhere a child of God will not face trials and temptation. There is nowhere. No way it's written. But this temptation is the only thing that will propel you, that will give you what we call promotion. Is that temptation? Now, if you know the God you are serving, all you need to do is to burst into praise and worship when the temptation comes. Don't give up. Keep on praising God. He shut this door and he opened the other door. Praise the Lord. He shut that door. That means that door is not good for you. He opened another door for you. And one is going to open for you. Be the best. God can't give you less. God will always give you the best. Do you know we are panicking so much? Why? Because we are flesh. Oh, it's too late. I don't know why God is doing it, including me. It's not only you, because we are flesh. We have flesh and blood. So we panic. But let our panic not be up to our praise. Let our praise be more than our panic. If it becomes too much, give it to God. Leave it there, leave it there. Take your problems to the Lord and leave it there. He will surely deliver you when you put your trust in him. Take your problems to the Lord. When the problem and the challenges becomes too much, give it to the owner. God is the owner of your soul. He knew everything about you. He knew everything about me. He knew everything about your family. Give it to God. He's the all-powerful God. The challenge is not for you alone. Maybe the challenge comes in order for you to be enthroned and not to be dethroned. In fact, you are too on the ground. So God wants to elevate you. So when the challenge comes, why must you cry? God is aware. I say, God is what? He's aware. Where you are going, no devil will stop you. Praise the Lord. First book of Chronicles, chapter number 15. I will start from there again, verse 25. You see the case of David. Amen. So David, the elders of Israel, and the captains over thousands. What verse did I say? Verse 25 of First Book of Chronicles, chapter 15. So David, the elders of Israel, and the captains over thousands went to bring up the ark of the covenant of the Lord from the house of Obed-Edom. With what? With joy. They went and bring the ark of the covenant of God from the house of Obed-Edom because they despise Obed-Edom because he's a poor man. And they put the ark of God in his house. They wanted him dead. But this man knew the importance of the ark of God, the presence of God. And he maintained it, he kept it well. And God began to visit the family, began to visit the man, and he was blessed. So when they heard of it, David decided, oh, is that true? We are going to bring back the ark of God back to our place. So he summoned all his people. We are going. And they all went. Verse 26. So it was when God helped the Levite who bore the ark of the covenant of the Lord that they offered seven bulls and seven rams. You know what it is? From their heart. They offered everything. When we talk of thanksgiving, people will be saying, what are we thanking God for? What has he done? You are provoking God. You are telling God you are ready to go extra mile, and God is ready to go extra mile. Can your extra mile be up to God? David was clothed with a robe of fine linen, as were all the Levites who bore the ark, the singers, and Chenania, the music master, with the singers. David also wore a linen ephod. Do you see that place? Thus, all Israel brought up the ark of the covenant of the Lord with shouting, and with the sound of the horn, with trumpets, and with cymbal, making music with string instrument and harps. And it happened, as the ark of the covenant of the Lord came to the city of David, that Michal, Saul's daughter, looked through a window and saw King David whirling and playing music, and she despised him in her heart. Wow. Praise the Lord. Amen. And I want to let you know, each time you enter into a high praise, look at it. You will enter into a high praise, all your enemies will be eliminated. You enter into the realm of a high praise. No enemy will stand you. I've never seen any man or woman that is praising God and crying. One side, just one side sharing tears. You don't? No. You can only remember your past or your problems after you stop praising. When you are praising God, you don't remember your past. Don't remember what happened yesterday. It is until you keep quiet. You begin to think, oh, that man said. Oh, that woman said. But when you are on top of praise, you have put on God. You put on God. You are not yourself again. God is moving inside you. Praise the Lord. By them, you have disarmed all your enemies. Their weapon is on the ground, and they can't do you anything. God has taken over you. Praise the Lord. I say what? God has taken over you. Why? Because you have put on God himself. It is no more you. Well, let me tell you one thing. When God chooses you, it's not you again. The flesh is there. The body is there, but it's not you. Like I keep telling people, what you are seeing in somebody is ordinary sand, the beauty, the decoration. The person is inside. And when God takes over a man, God dwells inside the man. So when you embark on praise and worship, you see God is not you again. That is why each time you are praising God, you don't remember you are poor. You don't remember you are naked. You don't see yourself how you are dancing that. Oh, I'm not dancing well. You dance anyhow. And that's exactly what happened to David. David danced without looking back, without looking at his status. We call him what? King David, David. He never cared that he was a king. He was praising God, giving a quality praise to God. And a wife that he married did what? Despised him. Praise the Lord. We'll come back to that place. Let us look at the book of Isaiah 51. Amen. Isaiah chapter number 51. Sometimes we look at what praise is all about. Praise is not just because we are in the church. No. If it is because we are in the church, you see, the Lord will become more. It's supposed not to be only in a church. When you praise God, whatever enemy is doing against you is against God. That is against God. Will not be against you again because you have put on God himself. So whatever enemy wanted to do to affect you, the person will be in trouble. Because you want God to be blind. Can God be blind? So it becomes a reverse case. Because you have put on God. Verse 11. Isaiah 51 verse 11. And the Bible says, so the ransom of the Lord shall return. So the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with what? With singing, with everlasting joy on their heads. Look at it. They shall obtain joy and gladness. Sorrows and sighing shall where? Flee away. Why? Because you have put on God. When you put on God, what happens? Let me tell you, he paid a price for you. He's the one that redeemed you. We say we are the redeemed, but we are not doing what is expected of us. After we teach Bible, we not do what is in the Bible. We not do what we taught, which means we are hypocrites. When we do what is written in the Bible, let us do it. Let us practice it. Let us, in fact, bring it to people. Let people know about it. If you look at this very verse of scripture, the redeemed, the ransoms of the Lord shall return. The ransom of the Lord shall return. The redeems of the Lord shall come back. He paid a price to redeem your life. You will come back to God. Now look at it and come to Zion. With what? With singing. When God bailed you out of your trouble, where do you go? When we say, come and give thanks to God, many of us don't understand thanksgiving. We don't understand thanksgiving. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So think thanksgiving, you are coming to give to pastor. Even if you bring 100 cows here, God see it before you bring it. God see your heart before you bring it. And if it's not pleasing to God, you just waste your money. And when you are coming, you come with nothing. You have nothing because you have nothing, but your heart is open. You will see God accepting your praise and worship, accepting your thanks offering. If you bring cow and God did not accept it, anyone that eat it, they are just eating meat, ordinary meat. Blessing will not be there. But the moment it comes from your heart, God knew. Before you drop it, he has packaged your blessing. He has planned what he wants to do with you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing, with everlasting joy on their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, sorrow and sighing shall flee away. You have no pain. You will have no distraction anymore. By that time, whatever is done against you will also be against God. And the Bible said, it is fearful to fall in the hand of God. If anyone is against you because you are doing the will of God, the person will be in trouble. Will be in trouble. Anyone. You are standing here because you are coming to church. They want to hinder you. They want to disturb you. The person is fighting against God. And once that person is fighting against you, God will rise against such persons. That's the way you say, God, arise for my sake. Let my God arise. Let my God arise. And your God will arise in his anger. It will not just be only arise. Arise in your anger. And when God arises in his anger, all your enemy will be scattered. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, you see Michel, we call Michel David, look at it. Despised David, her husband. Yes, why? Because he was dancing and praising God. So she was under a curse for despising a praiseful heart. Take note of that place. She was under a curse for despising a praiseful heart. Despising a man that see the heart of God, that was giving God his food. He was willing to look like a stupid person, a foolish person, in order to praise his God. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. David was willing to look stupid, so foolish, in the eyes of everybody, provided he did what? He pleased his own God, not man, not President Obama. No. He was willing to be stupid, even to be naked, provided his God would be happy with him. When we talk, let us pray. Let us pray. Come and pray. You see people going like this. I don't know what they are doing. I don't know what they are looking for. I don't know what loss. Okay, let us praise God. Oh, let my cloth not dirty. And if you are cloth dirty, what happens about that? No more soap. No more water. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say praise the Lord. David was willing to do what? To look stupid, to look foolish in the eyes of people, provided he gave a thankful heart to God. Provided he is praising God according to his heart desire. Provided he give God his own food. And which time you praise God, you provoke God. just like I tune you when you begin talk. Because you have given him all his requirement. I cannot praise God and say, oh, God, you can't do it. God must do it for me. If I praise God with all my heart, I know God will hear prayer. He will hear my prayer. If he has heard one person's prayer before, he will hear my own. And this applies to you. You can't pray to God without you praising God. Are you commanding God? God, I command you, come and do this for me. No. You have to lobby him with your praise. You have to go in a normal channel. When you lobby God and God is happy, he can go extra mile because of you. By the time the enemies will rise up against you, God will silence them. He will disarm them. They become a dog without teeth. That is barking. It can't do you anything. That is what witches are. If you are following God and witches are tormenting you, let me now tell you the truth. Begin to praise God. Give him his food. They will be like a dog that had no teeth. They can't do you anything, provided you're upright. I don't say offend them and begin to praise God. You'd find trouble. I don't want to tell you bad thing. That is the right thing. You don't offend anybody and begin to tell God to fight my battle. You find trouble. And God will overlook. Say, well, since you find trouble, it's up to you. You have to bear the cost. But when you are upright, you will see God moving with speed. We slay all your enemies. Psalm chapter number 9, verse 1. We look at this verse of scripture. I will praise you. Look at, are we there? I will praise you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will tell of all your marvelous works. I will praise you with all my heart. I will tell of all your marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in you. I will sing praises to your name, O Most High. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you look at verse 3. When my enemy turn back, they shall fall and perish at your presence. Our inward attitude becomes outward expression when we praise. Inward attitude becomes what? Outward expression when we praise God. If you look at how the world is today, in the world, Michelle, look at his, whoever at that time was fiancée as David, as a military conqueror. She loved her, loved him. Now, if you look at it, when David became a king, she was still in love with David. But why must it be that when David was dancing to his maker, his wife despised him? Is that good? It is bad. A military conqueror, yes, he's a man of war. He put on better dress. Now they put him a king. They made him a king. He sat on the throne. He said, man, it's my husband. Now the man who decorated him, who wanted you to stand by him, he was dancing for him, bringing the Ark of Covenant back to their country, to their Israel or Jerusalem. Now you see this girl or this woman spitting on David. Foolish man. Dancing naked in the street. But this man did not care. He was dancing, praising his God. I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart. With my whole heart. I will praise the Lord. Blessed people, praise the Lord. Did you see that place? You keep on dancing. Keep on praising God. What, no matter what happened, praise God in every of your circumstances. And when you are praising God, God will open your eyes. It's too hard. It's too difficult, but God knows the way out of your predicaments. God knows how he will channel your ways. It's tough, yes, of course. It must be tough. Are we not a human being? Once we are a human being, we must face challenges. And when we face challenges, let me tell you the truth, with a good conscience, you will see God proving that he is God. To follow God has no two ways than to follow his commandment. He's laid down rules. There is a rule from God that we must follow if we are genuine Christians. If we are genuine Christians, there are ways we will follow God and God himself will be pleased. God himself will be pleased. We cannot follow God and follow him and miss. When we follow God with all our heart open to him, we begin to see God proving himself in our lives. Praise the Lord. We should not be afraid to express our mind towards God. So whatever expression, what we think it is appropriate, we must use it. Whatever. We think it is good to praise God. Is it dancing? Is it screaming? Is it jumping? Use it. God will be pleased with it. You don't follow God and follow him without gaining from him. Isaiah chapter number 12. Isaiah chapter number 12, verse 1. And in that day you will say, O Lord, I will praise you. Though you were angry with me, your anger is turned away. And you will comfort me. We express our gratitude by praising him, telling others about what he did. We will praise him by telling others for all and about all he has done in our life. Our praise must be a standard one. Must be a standard one. God cannot heal you from sick bed. When you get up, you say, "Na morning, my mess don't go far." Instead of you giving praise to God, because the reason God brings you back, he has a reason for bringing you back from the pit of death. He has a reason for reviving you. But if you don't know, you always think of money, the money you did not make that 6 months you were sick. May you not sick of. If you see sickness, you will not, even you say, take money, take everything, but give me good health. That's what you say. Yes. I passed through it, so I know about it. So if I see anybody that is saying he's sick, I pity that person because what is passing through, you may not know. Now, God healed you. What must you do? I've sacrificed my own life for God. No matter what I'm seeing, no matter what I'm passing, I've sacrificed my own because I want to praise him to the fullest. I have no job than to praise God. Don't, you always encourage me, don't discourage me. So if you are here and God has done one good thing for you and you don't know, when will you know? When will you remember what he has done? When will you remember what he has done in your life? And in that day you will say, O Lord, I will praise you. Though you were angry with me, your anger is turned away. And you comforted me. Can you imagine? Can't you praise God? You give him praise. Quality praise. Praise that money cannot even buy. Give it to God. He was once angry with you, but now he turned away the anger away from you. And he did what? He comforted you. Can't you praise him? What happened if he allowed the punishment to be upon your head? What happens? What happened if you, because he allowed you, you will sit there and die? What happened? Can you hold him? Can you blame him? Now he turned away those sickness. He gave you freedom. He gave you good health. And you still find find it difficult to praise him. Oh, money is not enough. Oh, my clothes is... God bless you. If now your child become a problem that you will not serve God again. God bless you and give you a work. That work become a thorn that you will not come to church. Ah, my God. Now, what do you want God to do for you? He take away sickness from you. He bail you out of trouble. He remove debt on your way. He gave you children. He gave, but still, those are the children he gave to you. He said, oh, you don't have work. Okay, give him work so that these children will feed. He said, that work again made you not to come to serve God. Who is blaming who? Who is cheating who? You are doing yourself. Because you don't know the next level he would have taken you to if you are praising him. If you are doing what is expected of you, you don't know the level he's going to take you. You don't know the plan he had for you, that all the days of your life will be a day of a palm tree. You will be rejoicing and your children will flourish. You don't know, but you break it up. You tell God, I'm sorry, the work you gave me is more than enough. Let me do the work. I don't have time now. When I get time, I will come to church. Can you imagine? And in that day you will say, oh Lord, you, I will praise you, though you were angry with me, your anger is turned away. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, if you look at it, we express our gratitude by praising him and telling others about what he did. You become a dangerous warrior when you were fully armed with what? With praise. You become a dangerous warrior. And nobody will dare you. You are passing, you will pass first before they start talking. In your presence, they will say nothing. But it is until when you have gone far, look at now, you see now, see how he's dressing now. See, God, maybe the thief. That's the truth. Why? Because God has fought your battle to the fullest. And everything is moving according to the will of God. That's why each time I said, please, let us do it the way of God. When we are doing it the way of God, then maybe they must say something. Backbiters will always remain at the back. And you'll be moving forward, they will be backbiting. You don't care about that. All you do is to praise God. Give God his food. You know how to dance, dance. You know how to sing, sing. You know how to exalt, exalt. And that is the truth. Leave those people that want to mechanize power. Leave those people that think when they prophesy, if I prophesy for you and you are not walking towards it, the prophecy will not come to pass. It is until you walk towards what God said that you will begin to see the manifestation. How will you walk towards it? You must serve him. You must be in the same chapter with him, in the same page with him. If you are not in the same page with him, he's not going to manifest. He's not going to walk. God is not a man that should lie. Once he has prophesied in your life, the prophecy will come to pass. For the prophecy to come to pass, you must be involved. God must also be what? Involved. Praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Nothing escapes your judgment when you praise God. If you are praising God, is pleasing to God. Everything you say will come to pass. If you are praising, it's according to the will of God. No man, no woman will trouble you. When they dare, they will be in trouble. Can we look at the case of Paul and Silas? Acts of Apostles, chapter number 16. All right. Acts of Apostles, chapter what? Chapter number 16. I will read it from verse 22. Then the multitude rose up together against who? Against Paul and Silas. And the magistrate tore off their clothes and commanded them to be beaten with rods. And it's not enough. They were careless about the beating. And when they had laid many stripes on them, They threw them into prison, commanding the jailer to keep them securely. Having received such a charge, he put them into the inner prison and fastened their feet in the stocks. But at midnight, everybody say at midnight.
At midnight.
What happened at midnight? Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Can we read that place together? One, two, go. You see that place? They were singing. They threw them, undermining the torture they gave to them. They threw them into the prison and fastened their leg. And two of them start singing, and the prisoner was saying, upon the whole beating. And these ones were still singing and praising God. Where was God when they were tortured? Praise the Lord. The God that made them to be in the prison has a reason. I want to let you know this. He has a reason why he made them to enter into that place. There are some that will give their life. There are some people that he's looking for, that God Almighty is waiting to arrest. He knew that the beating will not be anything to Paul and Silas. The beating will not kill them. Did they give them poison? Did they bury them alive? They only beat them and put them into the prison. They want to test the heart of Paul and Silas. Are they really serving me? And they keep singing, despising the beating. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
They despise the beating. Paul and Silas praise despite their circumstances. Remember, they were beaten and thrown into the jail. And they became more serious about their praise and prayers. Praise the Lord. 26, suddenly, there was a great earthquake so that the foundation of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were open and everyone's chains were loose. Can we say hallelujah to God?
Hallelujah.
Through their praise, I don't know what you are facing today. When you praise God, where the enemy may have tied you, they will lose you.
Amen.
When you praise God, I said, anywhere they may have chained you to be slaughtered this year, I said, they will lose you.
Amen.
They will let you go free.
Amen.
You will not die.
Amen.
None of your family members will die.
Amen.
When you praise God, you stand out for your families.
Amen.
No one will die in your presence.
Amen.
The Bible told us that the number of our days will be fulfilled. We will not die young.
Amen.
One man of God said that he will die before his wife so that the wife will take care of him. But number one, before he died, he will finish all his journey in life. They are showing that everyone must die. Have you? So you are dead will not cause trouble.
Amen.
You will finish all your assignment.
Amen.
And when you are going back, the heaven will be declared open.
Amen.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Amen.
You will not be thrown into hellfire.
Amen.
Because you want to praise God, as you are praising God, God will be manifesting his work on your behalf.
Amen.
As many as wanted you to be thrown into jail this year, all of them will go back to jail.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In verse 27, the Bible said, and the keeper of the prison awaking from sleep and seeing the prison door open, supposing the prisoners had fled, drew his sword and was about to kill himself. Did you see that place? They wanted to kill themselves. Oh, what they trusted into, we will go to jail again, or they will kill us. So let us die first. Is that not what he said? They wanted to kill themselves. But Paul, being a man of God, that God is inside him like he was inside Moses. God was inside Moses. God was inside Paul. Saul, why persecuted thou me? But say, who are you, my Lord? And the man entered. He said, I will take you to where you will suffer for my sake. He was beaten. He was tortured. Paul called with a loud voice, saying to yourself, know what? No harm, for we are all here. We are all here. No one missed. Why did they not run? If you can ask me. Why did these people still stay when they were loose? The chain, the door, everywhere was open, but they were still standing, watching. Then Paul shouted, do yourself no harm. We are all here. Then he called for light, ran in, and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. Did you see that place? The jailer ran and brought in light and fell down. Said, where is the man? Paul and Silas. They trembled. They fell down, rolled in their feet. They rolled in their foot. And if you look at this very verse of scripture, and he said, brought them out. Did you see? Brought them out. And look at it, and verse 30. And he brought them out and said, sirs. Did you see now? Sirs. What must I do to be saved? If it's only that, he has done something. If it's only that God did in their life, God has done much. Sirs, somebody you beat now, somebody you throw into jail, somebody you bind his leg and feet, and throw into the inner, they asked you to take care of them so that they, and you are now saying, sirs, what must I do to be saved? My Father and my God, all our enemies will bow to us. Amen. In this America, they will bow to me. Amen. They will bow to you.
Amen.
They will come and worship the God you are worshiping.
Amen.
That is what this man said. And he brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? So they said, they believe. On who? On the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved, and all your household. God will rise and honor.
Word Liberation Ministries. Liberating the world with the Word of God.